Okay, you've been doing something very interesting lately.
So yesterday, or maybe it was Friday, I forget which day it was. All the days are a blur. I was going to Microsoft CoPilot, which used to be Bing AI, whatever. So
You're right.
Microsoft's made some changes. That's now copilot.microsoft.com, or if you're on a Outlook or a 365 plan at work, it's copilot.cloud.microsoft.com, whatever. You know how Microsoft is with naming. So I went there, and the new interface had a little button on it that said "Think deeper," or I think it was just "Think deeper" or whatever. So I clicked on it because I figure why not, and it told me about new things that Copilot can do, and one of them was I will help you build an app. And I thought, well, that's interesting, because there are plenty of app tutorials on the web that you can go see. And I used to program apps. I used to be more into programming, but I'm kind of an old school programmer. And a lot of the stuff that I would use today, I've never seen fully deployed. I need to use a tutorial to see how you would go about doing it, especially when you're using cloud infrastructure and such. So I gave it an app idea, and it walked me through a pretty comprehensive way of getting that app up and running. And so before our podcast today, I did a example in 10 minutes, and I thought I'd walk through what happened in 10 minutes. So, and then I'll talk about the other app that I've been playing with and what it can do. So today I just said, I'd like you to help me develop the idea for a mobile app and then help me code it up. So a very broad statement of just, hey, I want to make an app. I don't even have an idea. I want to, have you help me code it. So then it said, well, what kind of app do you want to do? Do you want to do a game, a productivity tool, social app, something entirely different? So I thought, well, a game would be fun. And I've been playing a lot of word games recently. What would be a good word game? So I said, maybe a word game where you get a list of related words and have to figure out the target word that everything is related to. So the app would tell you ice, runny nose, and hot, and you'd have to guess that the related word is cold. So it came up with a rough outline, and it said, do you want to start by sketching out the user interface or jump right into coding? And I said, well, I want to jump right into coding. I'm going to use the Flutter framework. So I already have Flutter installed on my
And
laptop,
this
and
is you're using Microsoft CoPilot, right?
yep, Microsoft CoPilot.
Okay, to for a Google programming language.
Yes, for a Google programming language. Exactly.
Okay.
So,
And are there is there anything you did here or are going to do as we discuss that requires CoPilot Pro, which I know you have a license for?
not that anything I saw. It wasn't anything that said I had to use Copilot Pro for any of this.
Okay.
So I'm not sure, if it would tell me that only, your subscription can do this. I did do it under the
Right.
account that has Copilot Pro.
That's interesting.
So it's a nice choice. Flutter is great for building sleek cross-platform apps. Let's break this down. So it gave me the code. It assumed I had Flutter installed, which was
Okay.
probably a fairly safe assumption since I even said I'm going to use this framework.
Right.
And it gave me a main.dart file, the complete file that had the basic structure for the game. I pasted it in after I created the new Flutter project, and it worked. It ran without a problem on Mac OS. And I said, well, that looks pretty good. Can you give me a set of, let's create a set of target words. I don't just want one because it used my example as the first. You only had basically the one word in there, cold. So it said, sure, here's four more. It generated the list of words. And it said, do you want me to integrate that into the code? I said, yeah, show me how that happens. So then it edited my main.dart file to include those. And then I tried running it and I got an error. And I said, this is not right. It's giving me this error because I figured I'll play dumb and just let it try to figure it out. So I pasted the error in, and it said, oh, yes, this is Dart's type system is strict about null safety. We need to ensure that this one valuable isn't assigned a nullable type. So it tweaked the Dart code. I pasted that in. I said, it's still giving me an error. So it tweaked it again. And I said, yeah, it's still giving me errors. Can you just give me the complete code for main.dart again with the fixes in it? Mm-hmm. It gave me that. I basically hit a control A and a control V and pasted it all in. And that ran just fine. So it fixed its own errors, which is pretty crazy when you think about it. I didn't have to do any Googling to troubleshoot those errors other than Nice. Asking CoPilot.
Right.
And then I said, okay, now for a final thing, I want you to add 20 more sets of words and a scoring system so the user knows how many they've gotten right. And it did that. It gave me the new main.dart. I ran it, and I put the screenshot end result in our show notes. But from start to finish, it was 10 minutes to do all of that.
Amazing.
Yeah, it is really crazy. And of course, there's some UI tweaks I'd want to make, and there's some, sure, you know, other features I'd want to add in. There's no persistence in scoring. You know, there's no, it doesn't auto advance to a new game when you get this one right. There's a lot of things I'd add, but the idea that in 10 minutes I could get this from idea to off the ground is really kind of crazy to me, that happens that easily.
Yeah, I'm looking at all the screenshots you provided.
Mm-hmm.
It is amazing. Now I wonder, I'm going backwards. Why did it make so many errors in the first place? That's question number one.
Yeah, that is interesting. It knows that Dart doesn't like nulls, and yet it didn't safeguard against the null values. So that was kind of confusing. And it's also confusing that I copy and pasted the new code in snippets as it gave it to me, and it still gave errors. And then when I said, well, just give me the whole file again, then it was fine. So that was kind of bizarre as well.
I think that after the second error you pointed out, I think it would have been super hilarious if it told you, perhaps you should program this in C#. But no, this is fascinating. So what do you think now?
Well,
you know, this is, go ahead.
I mentioned that I did another app that had a little bit more functionality to it. The other app, I said I want to build out a a multi-user app, in a sense, that would store its data in the cloud. And I want to use Google Firebase, which I've seen, but I've never played around with much.
Yeah.
Again, this is a Microsoft product. I'm saying I want to use Google Firebase. And it said, sure. And it gave me all the steps I needed to set up a new app in Firebase, to download the Firebase admin and have it automatically provision all the API keys and everything that my app needed. And within less than an hour, I was writing and reading to a Firebase database. I had authentication set up. I had storage set up for pictures of some of things that people might upload, profiles. So again, for me, I told you this before the podcast, I'm an old programmer in a sense, where I think a lot about the way I would have done it 20 years ago with a SQL database and a LAMP stack and all of that stuff. So Firebase and a lot of the other cloud platforms out there that Amazon has and Microsoft has, I know that they have products and services that are much more tailored to storing data or storing values, you know, not necessarily in a rigid SQL structure or something along those lines. I've just never seen them in action. I've never used them. And so for me, having this walk me through was sort of like, hey, yeah, this is the newer way to do it, old timer. And this is what it would look like. And you can actually see it and now wrap your head around it a little bit better than someone who, you know, is coming into it fresh. Because I think if I was coming into it fresh, I wouldn't have these preconceived ideas. So this is one way to say, oh, that's what it looks like. That's how it would actually view in that console, or how I would make those changes versus the old way.
I should note that the good Dr. Westfall is considerably younger than me. So when he calls himself old, I'm like kind of stifling my chuckling. I just happened to pull this book out that was sitting next to me. As I go through my Swedish death clean, I'm going to keep this book. But speaking of old.
Ah, yes. Fortran 4 and the IBM 360.
Yeah. And I don't think I think I bought this used because what year is this? This is, where's the, the Library of Congress thing. Well, it's got the number, but you know, it doesn't have a copy. It might be so old there's no copyright because it didn't exist yet.